The Shokkjump Dragsta is a crazy orc vehicle designed for going really, really fast, and because of the shock attack gun that's built into its chassis, it's capable of making short jumps through the warp to go even faster. Now in this video we're going to show you how to paint this miniature, and because it's a speed freak model, we are of course going to show you how to paint it really quickly to get it on the tabletop straight away. And yes, this does involve painting it red. However, by following the methods and techniques we're going to show you, you'll be able to paint any of the Orc Buggy miniatures, and also you'll be able to do them in any clan colour by just changing the armour colour. But without further ado, let's get started. No matter which Orc Buggy it is that you're going to paint, as you're building it, you should always think about the sub-assemblies for it. And this is to enable you to access all the detail in the miniature, and it also allows you to undercoat the parts with different coloured sprays, which massively speeds up the painting process. For example, you can see here what I've done with my Orc Buggy. All the crew I've kept separate to allow me to access all that detail, and I've undercoated them using Xandri Dust Spray, which is a really good starting point for these particular miniatures. Now, for the main part of the chassis, I've undercoated it using Lead Belcher, and you can see I've got these two parts here left off as sub-assemblies. Now, these are to allow the crew to fit into the chassis easily, and this will vary slightly depending on which Orc Buggy it is exactly you're doing, but generally you're looking at parts, things like the roll cages that go on top just here, and also the rockets which then fit on top of that. So by keeping those separate, I can get the crew in later. And also I've kept the tyres separate as well, which I've undercoated using Chaos Black. Just really speeds up painting those. And with that done, we're then ready to start painting. Now the first colour we need is Lead Belcher, and this is to paint some metal details that appear on the tyres. We've got things like spikes, and there's also the hubcaps to do as well. So as always, remember to give all your paints a really good shake before you use each one. And the brush I'm going to use here is a medium base brush, which is a really nice size for the kind of detail we're doing here. Now throughout this video you'll see me use a palette, and I recommend you do the same. And what you do to use it is just get some of that paint on your brush and just put it onto your palette like this, because this means you can add a little bit of water to the mix. Don't need very much, just a little dot will do. Mix that in there, but what this does is thins the paint down so that it dries smoother so you don't see brush marks. It also gives you more control over where it goes, and it means it goes a bit further as well. So once you've got that mixed together, just make sure your brush isn't overloaded so you don't lose control of it. And then what you need to do is start painting in all the silver details that appear on the wheels. So for the most part we're looking at the middle, so you're looking at around here and then going down towards the axle in the middle there like that. But also we've got these spikes to do. Now when you're painting the spikes, don't worry about catching some of the black, because we will be neating that up later on. Just make sure you get all that silver detail before you move on. Once you've finished with Lead Belcher, you're then ready to put the tyres aside for the moment and start working on the main chassis, because what we're going to do now is start picking out some detail on it using Balthazar Gold. Now I'm going to be using the medium base brush to apply this once more, and as always use the palette to get the paint ready. So just like before, get a bit of that paint on there and then add a small amount of water into the mix. You don't need very much, just a little bit to thin it down. And then what we're going to do is just start picking out some details with this colour, because at the moment the main part of the buggy is a very large block of silver. So by adding some Balthazar Gold to it, we just make it a little bit more interesting. So what we want to do now is just start looking for some details that will look good in this colour. For example, we've got all these parts on the shock attack guns apparatus in the back here, so we can just start picking out some details like this, just to break it up a little bit, you see. Now also a good thing to pick out is some glyphs, such as the one just up on top here, but it's really up to you how much of this you do. If you want some ideas, then just check out the box artwork, and that'll give you some great pointers for details to pick out with this colour. Once you're happy with the bronze details, we're then ready to start moving on to adding some shade to the model. And we're going to be doing this on the chassis and the sub-assembly parts of it, but also on the metal parts of the tyres too. Now I'm going for Agrax Earthshade first for this. I'm going to be applying quite a lot of it, so I've got a large shade brush for this. And what you want to do is load the brush up with lots of this, but still use your palette, because it's a good idea to do so just to control how much you're applying at once, and also so you're aware of how much you're putting on at once. But to begin with, we want quite a lot, and all you've got to do is just start painting this onto the metal detail like this, letting it run into all those recesses like that. Now when you're applying quite a lot of shade like this, it will take a little while to dry, so you want to give your miniature around about an hour before you move on to the next step. And as it is drying, keep an eye on it, because you'll see that the shade tends to pool and collect towards the bottom of the model, and it's doing it quite a lot around there. When you spot that happening, just move away the excess paint with your brush like that, so that you don't get large blobs appearing on it. Once the Agrax Earthshade is completely dry, we're then ready to move on to the next colour, and this is going to be another shade. This time we're going to use Norm Oil, and the reason why we're doing a second shade here is because we want to make the metal really dark and really grimy in appearance, and this is the perfect way of doing it. Now the application is identical to what we did with Agrax Earthshade, still using the large shade brush and still using the palette just to make sure that we're not overdoing it, but still get a good amount on there, and then all you've got to do is start painting it all over. As before, keep an eye on it as it dries, as it starts to collect and pool in areas, but also be sure to give it plenty of time to dry. Once again, about an hour will be fine. And with the Norn oil completely dry as well, we're now ready to highlight all that metal. And to do that, what we're going to do is dry brush it using a colour called Necron Compound. Now, to do this technique, what you need first of all is a dry brush, and the ideal size for this is a large dry brush. And then what you do is just get some of the paint on the tip of the bristles of this brush, and then get hold of some tissue. And what you do is use the tissue to work the paint into the bristles like this, then to get rid of the excess as well. And the idea here is that you have only a very small amount of paint left in your brush before you start to apply it. So once you've done that, your brush wants to look something like this. And all you do then is look for your model and just start running the brush back and forth quickly across the texture. So for example, the shock attack gun, I'm going to start painting back and forth across it like this, and you'll see straight away the silver catches the sharper edges and gives me a really nice highlight really quickly and easily. So all you need to do now is carry on doing this across all the metal details, and this will include the tires as well, making sure you get the silver parts on those. And there we are, the metal is all highlighted, and now we're really ready to add some colour to the miniature. Now remember, we are doing ours in the colour scheme of the Evil Sons. However, if you're doing a different clan, at this point you'll want to start picking out some different colours for the armour. For example, if you're doing the Death Skulls, you'll want some Macragge blue, or the Goths, you'll want a Bad and Black, that kind of thing. But also at this point, you should, if you haven't already, make sure you change your water, because we have been painting with a lot of metallic paint. At this point, those paints will have contaminated the water quite heavily with little metal flakes. If you don't clean the water now, you will start getting these metal flakes appearing in your other colours, so it's a good idea just to do that now and get it out of the way. But the first paint we're going to be using is Mephiston Red for our colour scheme, and I'm going to be applying this mostly using a medium base brush, but it's a good idea to have a medium layer brush on hand as well, because it can be really useful for reaching all the tricky to reach areas. Whatever the case though, you want to make sure you thin your paint down with a little bit of water as before to make sure it's nice and smooth. And then it's really up to you exactly how much red you paint onto your miniature. Remember, if you're trying to paint this very quickly, you'll only want to do a small amount of it. But if you want to take a bit more time, apply a bit more red. For my example, what I'm going to be doing is painting on the front of the buggy, so this kind of area down here going all the way down to the front. I'm going to be painting the spoiler on the back in the middle and these side two parts on here as well, and also these bits of armour on the side. So you can see the kind of areas I'm going to cover. Now, as you're doing this, just be careful when you get close to the silver details. For example, around here, I'm just going to be really neat as I reach that part there, but it can be much quicker on the flatter bits in the middle. And also, don't worry about recesses for the time being, because we will be shading those later. Once you apply the red, if you can see some of the silver showing through, don't worry about it, because, well, that's the ideal, really. You've got a nice thin coat, and it's nice and smooth. Just let it dry, then apply a second thin coat in exactly the same way, and this way it stays nice and smooth, and you'll get a solid finish as well. I've finished base coating with Mephiston Red, and you can see what a massive difference it's made to the miniature. But we're not going to stop there for the colours on the armour, because we're going to add a bit of variety to it now to give it a kind of ramshackle look, which is perfect for orc vehicles. So first of all, we're going to add some Evil Sun Scarlet to some of the armour panels, followed by Corn Red, and then we're going to use some Abaddon and Black as well. First of all though, I'm going to use some Evil Sun Scarlet, and I'm going to be applying this in the exact same method as what we've just done. So I'm starting out with my medium base brush again, but I've still got that medium layer brush on hand. And I'm going to be painting this over a lot of the red panels we've done so far. Now you might be wondering why I'm doing this, but the reason is because that Evil Sun Scarlet is a layer paint and so is a bit transparent. Having Mephiston Red down first of all, which is a base paint, means we're going to get a much stronger red overall. And you'll see that straight away, because what I'm going to do is start by applying it on this armour panel just here. And what you need to do is just carry on painting this over all the panels that you want to be a brighter red. Next, pick out any panels that you want to be in a darker red using Corn Red. And finally, paint any panels that you want to be black using Abaddon Black. And there we are, once you're happy with all the coloured panels, you're then ready to shade them. And for this, what we need is Agrax Earth Shade once more, but this time the application's a bit different. We need a small layer brush for this, and what we're looking to do is to paint this directly into all the recessed areas on the armour. So that's why you need the small brush, you see, for lots of control over where you apply the paint. Use the palette just to make sure the brush isn't overloaded, and just bring the bristles to a nice tip by just twisting them like this. And then once you've done so, you're just looking for those recesses. So a really great example is on the front here, you can see that little one we've got connecting these two slightly different red coloured armour panels. What I'm going to do is just paint the shade directly into that little corner there like that to give a nice bit of definition to it. Also, you want to keep an eye out for any rivets, and when you see these, just dot the shade over it like that so it just runs around the rivet and shades all the way around it. And with the shading done, we can now add some highlights. Now, when you're painting a miniature quickly like this, what we should do is always focus on the main areas of colour, because they're the parts that you see the most. So for this, that means highlighting the red panels. And what we're going to do is dry brush them to highlight them using Wild Rider Red. Now, this time with the dry brushing, we need to be more controlled about where we're applying it, because we just want to hit those red panels. So I'm going to use a small dry brush for this. But the technique is very similar to what we did earlier. Still use a bit of tissue just to work the paint into your brush like this, and then use it to get rid of the excess as well, just making sure that you don't have much on there. And then this time when you start start to apply it, just take your time making sure you're painting it in the right kind of area. So for example, on the front just here, what I'm going to do, rather than flicking the brush across the whole area, is just focus it towards the corners of the red armour like this, so that I'm not catching the black or the silver details, but instead I'm just catching the edges of the red armour panels like this. So just really take your time as you're working around the miniature. There we are, we've finished the red of the armour, but I just want to point out I have painted this little targeting squig in here, and he's been painted following the exact same method as painting all the lighter red armour. Now with that done, we're now going to start doing a bit of weathering on the model because we want to make it look quite battered and worn, and this is a great way of highlighting things quickly as well and really finishing it off. To do it, what we need is Skaven Black Dinge, which we're going to apply with a little bit of sponge, and then we need some Lead Belcher, which again we're going to use a bit of sponge to apply. We're also going to apply a small amount of it using a brush as well. But first of all, we need Skaven Black Dinge, and the little bit of sponge you need is just kind of like this, just a small little piece just torn off like that. And what you do is just get a bit of paint on the end of it. So just a little dab of the paint on like that, and then just use the palette to make sure there isn't too much on here. You can see as I start dabbing it on like this, I'm getting quite a random pattern, and this is going to appear as kind of chipped paint on the miniature. You want to get it down so it's applying roughly that kind of amount with each press, and then what you do is just start applying it towards the edges of the armour on your vehicle. So for example, if I start around the front here, what I'm going to do is start dabbing it on like this, and you can see it gives a really nice effect to the paint chipping away and showing the undercoat beneath. Once you're happy with the Skaven Black Dinge, you're then ready to move on to Lead Belcher to repeat the technique, only this time just a little bit lighter than before and following along the same kind of areas. And finally, continue using Lead Belcher, but this time apply to the small airbrush. And what you can do here is just use this just to connect some of these chips to give a little bit more shape to the body of the vehicle. So for example, just going along there, you can see it acts as a kind of highlight, just helping define the shape of the front. It also means you can get to some of the more tricky to reach areas that the sponge couldn't quite get to. For example, just along the front of here, so you can add a few chips in logical places like this. And there we are, the chipping on the armour is complete, and we can move on to the next detail, which is to finish the tyres. Now remember earlier on when we were base coating with silver on them, it could be a little bit messy, especially when you're dry brushing the highlights on those parts. So what we need to do first of all is neaten this up using a Baden Black. Now after that we're going to highlight the tyres by dry brushing them using Dawnstone, and then we're going to add a little bit of a weathering effect to them, a kind of dusty effect using Steel Legion Drab, again dry brushed on. But first of all we need a Baden Black, and I'm going to be applying this with my medium base brush again. And as always, you just need to use your palette here to get that paint ready. So just thin it down so it's nice and smooth. And once you've done so, what you need to do on your tyres is essentially start painting all the rubber parts with this colour. So what you need to do is just be careful around the silver details, just painting up to them like this. But then just be sure to paint the flat of the tyre as well to make sure the black is nice and consistent all the way around. Also at this stage, just keep an eye out on the main hull of the buggy for any cables or any wires. And if you spot any, base coat them with the Baden Black as well. Once you've painted the rubber black, the next thing to do is to highlight it using Dawnstone, which we're going to dry brush on with a small dry brush. And to do this, what you want to do is see that ridge running around there? You want to paint downwards, going across it, and just slowly work your way around the tyre like this. And once you finish doing that, we're then going to finish off with a very light dry brush of Steel Legion Drab across the tread of the tyre. So just very lightly to give a slight dusty impression like this. And with that dry brush applied, the tyres are complete, and now we're going to return to the main chassis of the buggy, because the next thing we need to do is add a few little weathering effects onto that part. First of all, we're going to use some Baden Black to add a sooty effect onto the exhausts, and then we'll need Typhus Corrosion for a bit of grit and grime. But first of all, with the Baden Black, what we're going to do here is stipple it on very lightly. So you need a small dry brush for this, and it's a lot like dry brushing in fact with this. You just get a small amount of that paint on your brush and get some tissue, use it to work it in amongst the bristles. But then when you apply it, this time, rather than brushing it on, you want to kind of stab it onto it. So looking at the exhaust, just around here, what I'm going to do is start stabbing it on like that, so I get a darker buildup of black just around the exhausts there, like that. And then we're going to add a little bit of Typhus Corrosion using a small airbrush, and for this all you do is just paint it in some of the recesses for a buildup of grease and grime. Now another thing you can do with this is also add some streaks on it towards the front of the buggy, so just going vertically up like this to give an impression of speed. And with those weathering effects added, we're now ready to move on to one of the very cool distinctive features of this particular miniature, and that is the shock attack gun, because we've got to paint the glowy bits on it. Now to do this, we need a base coat of Stegadon Scale Green, and then we're going to add some Araman Blue, followed by Baharoth Blue to complete the effect. But first of all, we need Stegadon Scale Green, and I'm going to be applying this using a medium layer brush. And as always, you want to use the palette here to get your paint ready, especially for this first part, because we do need quite a lot of control here. So get that paint thinned down, and make sure your brush isn't overloaded. And then we're looking to pick out very specific areas of the orbs on the back. So you can see we've got the array of the shock attack weapon just around here. We're looking at these orbs, and what we want to do is to paint this circular bit just in here, Just being careful of that silver ring that's going around it. So basically around there, then skip that ring and start painting the actual orb itself, again avoiding these little nodules as you go along, like this. You want to do this for all five of these, and also at the same time, we can take a look at the computer screen that's inside the cab of the buggy. That's just down here. Be sure to base coat this at this point as well, and any targeting lenses you can find too. With that base coat done, the next step is to thin down Araman Blue with some water and, using a small airbrush, just run it into the recess that goes around the inside of this ring and also on the outside of it too, so you get a brighter blue glow around that detail just there like that. Now also, we've got to paint the screens on here, and for the one that's on the inside of the cab, what we're going to do is just paint a line running down the left-hand side of it, so just down there, and also along the bottom. And once that's dry, repeat the process using Baharoth Blue, again thin down with lots of water and just run it into the recesses around these metal rings. Now again on the TV screens, the way to finish these is painting lines just as previously, but just a little bit further towards the corner using narrower lines. And there we are, the effect for the shock attack gun is complete, and also so is the screen on the inside of the cab. And now we're going to move on to the next step because, well, we've actually finished the chassis of the buggy and all the wheels, so all we've got to do now is to paint the crew. Now, because we're showing you how to paint this miniature really quickly, we're going to use a speed painting method for the crew. And this is a method that actually works really well in Orc Boys as well, especially if you want to paint a large number of them, for example, if you want to do 30 or so. What we're going to do is concentrate on the most important parts of the miniatures, which for Orcs is the skin and their armour colour. Now, remember earlier on we undercoated the miniatures using Zandri Dust, and the reason for this is because we're actually going to be using a lot of layer paints rather than base paints to get the colours in quickly. So having Zandri Dust is a really great mid-tone from which all the layer paints will apply very nicely. The first colour we need is Warboss Green, and this is for their flesh. And I'm going to be applying this using a medium base brush, but you might want to have a medium layer brush on hand for this. But what you need to do is, as always, use the palette to get that paint ready. And we're aiming just to paint the skin here. Don't worry about being too neat, but where you've got areas that later are going to be bone coloured, for example the teeth, try and be neat around those parts. That's the only part you really need to concentrate on in that case. But what you do is, for the flesh, just base coat this, not worrying about those details like the helmet and things, but as you can see, I'm just being really careful to avoid the teeth. Now that we've finished blocking in the skin, we're ready to move on to the next few colours on the miniature to carry on, well, blocking all the main areas of detail. And we're going to start out with Evil Sun Scarlet, because we're painting the Evil Suns clan, of course, but if you're doing a different clan, you'll want a different colour there. Then after that, we're going to use Lead Belcher to base coat all the metal details. Now after that, we need to base coat all the remaining bits of clothing, and for this, we're going to be using Gorthor Brown and Eshin Grey. But if you want to include more colours here, that's entirely up to you. You might want to maybe use a Baden Black as well, but that's your choice. First of all though, we need Evil Sun Scarlet, and I'm going to be applying this with my medium layer brush, and what I'm going to do here is look for any bits of armour really that I want to be this colour. If you want any clothing to be this colour, it's again your choice, but I'm looking for things like the helmet that he's wearing. So as I'm blocking in this colour here, I'm just going to be really careful not to get it on the skin, and I'm also going to be applying two thin coats of it. Next, base coat all the metal details using Lead Belcher. Next we're onto the colours for the materials of the fabric, and first of all we're going to use Gorthor Brown, which I'm going to use to pick out any leather details like the belt around here, but also some of the layers of the clothing, for example the sleeves. And finally, painting the remaining fabric using Eshin Grey. I've finished blocking in all these colours onto the crew, and with that done, we're now ready for the next step, which is to shade them. And for this, we're just going to paint Agraxa shade all over them to shade all these colours at once. I'm going to be applying this using a medium shade brush, which is a really good size for the kind of area that we're covering here. And all you got to do is get a good amount of this paint onto your palette, load up your brush, and then all you need to do is just start painting it all over them. Now, miniatures like this that don't have a base of their own, it's just about inevitable, really, that you'll get some of this paint on your fingers. But don't worry about that. Just make sure that you get a nice even coat settling nicely in the recessed details, and then give it about half an hour to dry. Once the shade is dry, you can see the miniature is completely transformed with all that detail standing out nicely. And what we need to do now is, well, highlight the miniature. And what we're going to do is, again, focus on those parts that are the really important ones. And on Orcs, one of the big ones to do is the flesh. And for this, we need Scarsnik Green. Now, I'm going to be using a small airbrush to apply this. And what we're looking to do here is to really accentuate all the main features of the flesh. So to help out with doing that, what you must do is make sure your paint's flowing really smoothly from your brush by just making sure it's watered down with a little bit of water. And then very importantly here, just twist the bristles together to bring them to a nice point so you have lots of control over it. And then what we're looking to do is to look for those sharper features and just pick them out by painting lines of this colour. So if we take a look at the face, I'm looking for sharper edges. So for example, we've got the top of the nose, so I'm just going to paint along there like that. And then there's the cheekbones, so I'll just go up to them like that. And then we've got the top of the mouth just here, so I'm going to just paint some lines running across here to build up that texture. and then just follow those little lines running down there like that. And you can see what I'm doing here is just making all those features just stand out a little bit more by just, well, following along them like this. And with that skin highlighted, we just have a few more details left to highlight to finish off the miniature. And first of all, we're going to highlight all the red armour using Wild Rider Red, and then we're going to chip it using a little bit of Lead Belcher in a very similar way to what we did on the actual main chassis of the buggy. Now, after that, we're going to use Necron Compound to highlight the silver details, and finally, we just need a bit of a Shabty Bone to paint in the teeth. But first of all, we need Wild Rider Red, and again, I'm using my small airbrush, and because the red is quite an integral part of the areas we painted here, rather than dry brushing like we did on the buggy chassis, instead I'm going to use this just to pick out the edges on those details. So again, just get the paint thinned down, just like we did for the skin, and then once you've done so, all you've got to do is look for the sharper edges on the red armour. So on the helmet, you can see there's quite a few sharp edges running around the front of it. All I'm going to do is just run my brush around those edges like that to get a nice highlight. Then we need Lead Belcher to add a few chips onto the red armour. Now we can't use a sponge here because the detail's too fine, and if we use a sponge we'll get it on other parts. So instead just use a small airbrush and just paint small amounts just in the very corners of these details. The next colour we need is Necron Compound, and this is a dry brush, remember, to highlight all the silver details. Now a lot of these you can't quite get to because the dry brushing will catch other parts. So really what you're looking for are the silver details that stand out a lot. For example, this little control stick we've got here, I can easily get to this detail without catching the skin. Now a model such as Orc Boys, it's very easy to get to details such as shooters, but remember, if you're not sure if you can get to the detail without catching anything else, then don't worry about it. And finally, use a Shabty Bone to highlight the teeth. Now, once you've done this, you're ready to make the final assembly of your miniature. And for that, I definitely recommend that you use super glue. And with that done, you're then ready to base your model. And as always, we recommend you base it in the same way as the rest of your army. And with the final assembly made and the base completed, the Shokkjump Dragsta is complete, ready to take to the battlefield and tear through the enemy ranks like lightning. So in this video, we showed you lots of speed painting techniques to paint this model quickly. And if you're going to paint your model like this, there are a couple of things to remember. The first is to look for sub-assemblies, especially ones that you can undercoat in different colours. Colours that are appropriate to the main colour of that detail. And you find if you do this, it gives you a really good head start on painting the model fast. Now when you reach the stage of painting the armour red, remember you only need to paint the armour panels that you want to be red. So if you're in a rush, just do a few. But if you want to spend more time on the miniature, then feel free to paint as much of it red as you like. Finally, when you're doing the crew, again, we showed you how to paint these using speed painting techniques. And the main one of that is to concentrate on the important details. In the case of orcs, that's the skin and the colour of their armour. So there you go. We really hope you guys have enjoyed this video and learned something from it. And we really hope it helps you. And remember, you can paint any of the orc buggies following the techniques we've used in this video. And you can paint any clan you want to as well by just changing out the armour colours for the ones appropriate to your clan. So really hope you guys have enjoyed this, and we'll see you all again very soon.